pass it to the right, you have to get instructions to the coach. The example that I'm going to call those on the kids at trial is when I used to coach the other buildings at Bombay, these kids used to roll up in a suit and tie to training. Their gear in a straight line. And looking at them from afar, as a parent, I'd be like, man, I want my kids to be a part of that group. Yeah? If a parental group is yelling, screaming, fighting with their coach and amongst themselves, as another parent, what would you think about that group? It's not a group that you want to be a part of. Okay, so the perception of the club is, and the reputation of Faulkner is critical. It's bigger than the game, the tournament, the cup. It's bigger than that pass. It's bigger than your game time. There's nothing bigger than the perception of the club and the Faulkner Soccer Club. I hate to hear you lose. I wouldn't hear this. My kids playing state titles, and the coach there said to me, "Oh, John, could you help me? He's got three teams, and he's got to pick one of the internationals." And he said to me, "You know, I need to merge the three teams to form one really good team, so we can do internationals." Kind of like, kind of think to myself, "He's serious about this. He's an under-8. He wants to win the nationals." I had an under-8 boy who won the nationals last year. He won the national team. Last year, and I said to him during this year, after getting it out of his system, an 8-year-old kid, gun kid, playing for Melbourne City in Abu Dhabi in March, got it out of his system that the win doesn't matter, the national team didn't matter, the national tournament didn't matter, actually winning the cup didn't matter, what did matter was that he's getting better. Okay? So getting back to the win or the loss or the pass, you know, the perception of the club, there is nothing greater. Now, if we're unable to maintain a positive environment or a positive attitude to the team, the club, training, the game, whatever, you'll be asked not to attend. If you can't help yourself, which I understand, we'll ask you not to attend training. If it's serious, we'll ask you not to attend games. Okay? Now, I don't want to go down to the last point because I don't want anybody to win. You guys are a great club. Someone asked me once, well, you know, why come to Portland? Because I actually believe you guys have got a great player base in an area that nobody in Melbourne has. I come from Templeslope, Williams 5 minutes away. Yeah. I come here for a reason. And it's because of your kids, and the kids are good when they realize it or not. They just need to be channeled properly. And that's why I'm here. Part of that is the parental approach. Let the coaches coach. Any issues by the team manager or myself, let the players come out, let them enjoy themselves. The video that I'll upload is the message there is the players. Yeah, I want to play here, but I can't because I don't have audience, sufficient audio to so that everybody can hear. Okay, so there are no ones in that. I just need everybody to be clear about this. Okay? And everybody working together. It's for your kids, it's not for me, it's for your kids, your club. I should have put that up earlier. This has been on Facebook for years, social media. You know, encourage your kids. Don't yell out instructions to them. There's only one person that should be instructing the kids as how to play, and he's your coach. There are many people that have spoken about there's a famous NBA coach who has a child that plays, probably not amazing, some of yours, and he asked his dad, well, what should I do? And the famous NBA coach said, go speak to the coach. I'll put that up as well. Go speak to the coach, don't ask me. I coach, you know, whatever team it was in the NBA, it's an American basketball team. Maybe a hockey team, but he said, go speak to the coach. Yeah, so he's the one guiding the team. If you have confidence in him, my kid's playing in state titles today. I don't watch a single man play for you because I have confidence in the system, I have confidence in his coach. I don't need to be sitting there watching him, let alone instructing him. I don't need to be doing that. Then I gave him $50 as a person to do it, and I said, I'll see you at 1. Probably not 50. have confidence in the club place. Cool. Essentially, that's the message there. Game days. Slightly different from mini roos to juniors. The principles remain the same. Again, I've got a volunteer sheet out there. The nets don't magically appear at the back of those nets. They need to be put up. I don't want to be seeing the same parents week in, week out. They will. If we say nothing, they'll keep doing it. That's just not fair. Yeah, they probably did it for me year last year. I'm just guessing I wasn't here. But they will keep doing it, but it's just not fair. It's for, again, I said to the other people last week, it's for your kids. Don't do it for my kid, because I'll be in my kid. Do it for your own kids. Yeah? I'm here to do it for mine. I need you to do it for yours. Intra-club games, the coaches know you'll be playing each other. Again, it's not a competition. It's not the 15s versus the 16s to see who's a better player, better coach. Quick yes. It's more about the way they play and the way they've been taught. It's an opportunity for the coaches to get together and sort of work out how they can do things better so the team is playing better. It's not a tournament. It's going to be happening every week. You'll see it happening. I just don't need you to contribute to the... Well, I do need you to contribute to a positive environment. Okay, so things like that will happen. It's not a tournament. It's not a competition. And even if it was, I wouldn't care if you won or you lost. It's all about the goal. The only ones I really care about are the results. I wouldn't really start in 18s and plus. Cups and tournaments, again, this is for me, it's a development opportunity. It's an opportunity for you to get better. Equal game time. I should have mentioned that, it says mini roos. Equal game time for mini roos, not over the spans of the game, it's over the spans of some games. If it's an issue, let me know. Don't get broken or by a team map. Let me know. Okay. If we want to get everything, team manager's assisting, we'll work it out. Solution to the problem. Now, come juniors. Juniors are a little bit different. You have specific positions. You have game time is dictated by coaches. It's a little bit different. I'll get into that in a moment. Volunteer list, again, it's up to you. If you haven't filled it yet, we'll fill it in at the end of this session here. Plan progression. Example, hypothetical. If a 15, under 15's team needs players, in this example, that coach will ask me, hey, I need some players. Okay? Already, I would have asked, which I will do come February next year, I would have asked each and every coach, who is it that you want to reward moving up? Let's just say they get Peter from the under 14s. Peter from the under 14s would like to be asked me too. Peter from the under 14 team's parents will be asked, can we move your child up if we need to? If they say yes, that conversation is done. That happens before the requirement of a coach, the under 15, saying, hey, I need a player. They will ask me if I need a player. That 14's coach would have already nominated two players in sequence. I will go ahead and let that player know that he's required by the club to step up, in addition to his game, okay? That is the process. It's a coaching decision made by myself. It is not a team manager or a parent or a player decision as to who plays up. Yes, you play your team, at the discretion of your coach. But if players are required to move up, that is the process, okay? From sevens through to twenties. We're not going to sort of, you know, take from this team to this team, sure. coach at the lower age group wants to do. So it's not a, in February we don't decide for the whole year. And he probably say, when I ask him, you know, this is what we're going to do, probably nominate somebody else, or he or she, whoever it is. Yeah, so it's not a, this is a general process. That does not apply for the whole year. So it may change month to month.
So you're just saying if another team is short this particular week, you're going to ask.
Yeah, so under 15s coach would say I'm short.
Yeah.
I'll go to the 14s and I say, well, you know, who is it?
Yeah.
And I already know if it's say a third person that I haven't spoken to their parents with, I'll have to speak to their parents. So I'm just trying to, you know, preempt and say yes. Okay, so everybody's sort of aware of what the process is in terms of the player, the parent, you guys as to what's going to happen. Again, the number one priority for me is that all four of the teams operate smoothly. No coach owns the players. The players belong to the club, and the club is yours. Yeah, so I don't want any coaches sort of hijacking the process and say, oh, not my players, yeah, well, these are players. They're actually not the players. So, look, I just need you to be across it, but I know there was some issues last year with certain things, but essentially that's the process. The objectives. Okay, so again, we are a development-focused club. Take 18s and 20s out of it. Is our objective to win? It's actually not. Our objective is actually to get better. And if we win in that process, that's great. Okay? I just need you to be across that objective, yes.
With what you just said, the process you want to instill in the club is to make players better.
Is that previous screen or
screen? No, there's not a screen. Yeah. To make a player better, to reward a player is to win at the end of the day. If the player knows he's getting better and the team is better, the club should say to them, we do expect to win the next game.
Yeah.
Otherwise, they're on a upward scale to what? There has to be a goal to achieve. Otherwise, they're just playing.
Sure.
So, depending on the age group, but as they get to 15, 16, 17, 18, they're pushing to 18 reserves or whatever. There has to be that win mentality, otherwise they're just turning up. So the time factor is there, but I believe the win has to be at the start.
To me, the win is a byproduct of the government.
Right.
Yeah. So it's important.
That they aim for it. They can't just come up and say, I've got a plus.
Yeah. So it's, to me, it's similar to work. So,
yes.
You want to make money, and if you don't achieve that, then your drive to work lessens. Oh, I'm getting frustrated, I'm not making money in the rest. Now, my objective is to develop players. The win is lots of development in winning. Yeah, in terms of the grief and the determination to win that game, there is a lot of development in that, but it's not our primary objective. Our number one objective is actually our number two objective, which is to get better. And if we're getting better, then we'll win. That is not what drives us.
I understand that the underlying message from the coach pre-game talk is you actually get beaten up the opposition.
Sure.
Which the skills allow.
So,
and the training sessions allow mid-season and now when you get down, then I would imagine that that's the conversation versus maybe of course you're getting better, but it's great that you actually win.
Sure. So there may be an element in that in terms of win, for sure. But if we're going to win, for example, under 12 games, I'll give you another example that probably highlight this question. Under 12s and 13s, I'm so surprised as to how off their first touch passing shooting is. That is, to me, again, I'm a parent as well, that is a direct reflection of the winning mentality we have from 7s to the 12s. We're so focused on the team strategy and the formation and the result. I feel that we've missed on developing on the four pillars that we need to be working on in the skills acquisition phase. So yes, you are in the game phase, and there is a lot of game sense and game learnings that needs to take place at the 16s, I think. Yeah, at the 16s, okay, sure, it's a different phase for the skills acquisition, but it's not the performance phase, which is the 18s.
Yeah.
So yeah, we're learning game tactics and all the rest of it. But it's not, again, learning that to get better in the 18s and beyond, where it's only about the result. Yeah. 18s, you go to supercup, there's 200 kids trying. I'll give you another example. There was 18s trial at another club, NPI, there's 180 trialists, and literally the first component, we get going, we get 180 kids, if you can't juggle, we're just off. You started marking kids off, why was their first touch is off? Like, they couldn't, they haven't got the kind of rules, don't worry about winning the game or your own. Okay, so, again, 16s and down here, you don't have the game phase, yeah, you might, but again, we're getting better at that game phase, and it's not the performance phase that is in the national level. Now, our number one objective is our number two objective, that is to get better, not the 18s, 16s and down. Yes, we're getting better at playing games, but we're getting better. And it means that, you know, you don't win, that's okay. It's life's a marathon, it's not a sprint. The additional program. So, I've tried doing this at another club in 3 years, couldn't do it. When I came here, I called the senior team in there and I said, guess what, I've got this done. They're now doing this. Okay, so Boleyn, opened their eyes and doing this. Westgate, who are